Good morning, guys. Well, it's actually 5 to 1 in the morning, and I haven't got you facing me yet because I've got to tether you up with the charger cable. I ain't got a lot of battery left. It's not dead, but I figured I'll just plug it in. There we go. We're running on external power now. Right. On board, I am waiting for a video to finish uploading. Eventually it decided it was gonna upload. I kept encountering an error and it wouldn't upload, but after 4 or 5 attempts it has decided to upload. I've got an itch, hang on. I'm not trying to pick me bogeys, I just got an itch. If I want to pick me bogeys, I'd be going like that. Right. Well, that was rather random, wasn't it? I can't actually show you what I've been up to because obviously I'm tethered to the lounge, so to speak, because I can't go any further than the cable. But I've had a sort out of the containers and things that are in my closet in the hallway. Because I had loads of little bits and I was sorting out other little tubs as well, so I thought I might as well just sort the lot out while I was at it. That's why that bench is now clear of all tubs. So yeah, I'm happy with that. I've got a few bits and pieces on there. I've actually got a tub full of bulbs here I've got to put back in the closet. I forgot about that. More shit has been going in the bin. There's probably even more shit going to go in the bin because I've got other drawers and things I'm going to go through. I'm just in the mood to get a bit ruthless, as they say, and just chuck it. It's doing my head in. I'm getting pissed off, tripping over things, and some of it I might... There's a few things I might donate to charity, like... that Polaroid camera, because I'm not going to use it. I don't think it's actually worth a great deal, and might as well give back to charity, as I'm always taking, so to speak. Well, I suppose as I buy stuff from charities, I am technically giving in that sense, but... For some reason, I thought the cat's tail was his head. It's right there between the CD tower and that chair. If he hasn't moved it. No, it's still there. At first glance at the corner of my eye, keeping in mind that is my bad side, for some reason I thought that was his head. Anyway, I've been in a right old mood to build a model for my Lego town, but I've got the... Lego Builders version of Writer's Block, which I called, unofficially I called it Builder's Block, because I'm not feeling inspired. I know I've got 2 projects on the go. I've got the hospital and the fire station, which I suppose I could do the last floor for the fire station if I've got the parts, come to think of it. I might not. It's ridiculous. I've got all this friggin' Lego. I still don't have enough parts for my projects. I actually dread to think over the past 10 years how much money I've actually spent. And it's now 1 o'clock because my clock on the wall has just clicked. That click from that clock is meant to be the mechanism to trigger the animal sounds, but I haven't put batteries in that part. It's a fun novelty, but when it does it every hour, it does get on your bloody tits after a while, so I left the batteries out. Well, Mum never did ring. Maybe she got a bit tired. Especially if she's... works every day. I had a young lady contact me on Facebook earlier. She's one of my friend's sister, and she knows someone who's about to get rid of a bunch of bikes, and she wanted to know if I'd be interested, sort of give me first dibs, if you like, because she, well, in her words, she said, I know it's your hobby. I don't know how many's there. She estimated 4 or 5, could be more, could be less, you don't know. But apparently this guy is sort of downsizing and making space, which is pretty much what I'm doing at the moment. I don't know how much space I'm going to get. Depends how ruthless I decide to be with my junk. But something's got to give, because I am getting tired of tripping over shit and whatnot. Anyway, I'm going away from the main subject now. So what she's going to do, as he's pretty much only around the corner, he's walking distance from me. She's going to contact him tomorrow, find out a price and roughly how many bikes there are and whatnot. And with a bit of luck, either tomorrow, Sunday or Monday or whenever, I may have a bunch of bikes. God only knows where I'm going to put the damn things, if I get them. But, I don't even know if they're adults' bikes, kids' bikes. Not a clue. Well, actually, speaking of bikes, that guy that bought the blue classic rally from me, the blue mountain bike, he's still riding it around town. In fact, I saw him 4 times yesterday. He only saw me the once, though. Oh, goody, my video's processing, so I haven't got long to wait. That's good. I've got Nemo beside me. I think he might want a bit of a top-up in his dish. So far, my only plans for tomorrow is just to continue cleaning this shithole up. Well, picking up the junk and either binning it, I may actually change the liner in that bin because it's getting rather full and probably heavy with some of the shit I've thrown in there. That computer desk there is probably going to come out tomorrow and be cleaned, unless I can get the vacuum cleaner pipe underneath it, just to get up as much of the junk and crap as possible. Because I've already done this one when I was looking for my happy meds, which I found some, thankfully. Because when I do come off them, I really do get grumpy. And I do have a temper. I was just getting the key. Getting the charger cable over my knee, that's what that little tilt was. I was trying to think if there's any other jobs in particular I want to do. I don't think so. Well, bike parts I can't really throw out unless they are absolutely knackered, because obviously I need them. I cannot do my favourite pastime unless, well, actually it's not my favourite pastime. Well, I suppose it is. It's my favourite pastime that makes me a bit of pocket money. So, can't really afford to get ruthless with bike parts, I should say. I was going to say chuck them out. Unless they are knackered. It's the only way I'll chuck them out. Oh dear. Well, might tell it's about 1 o'clock in the morning, just looking at Facebook, because nothing is happening. Right. I think before I do play around with any more bikes, I really should get this lounge cleared up as much as possible. I've got a Lego tub over there I can stick underneath that table. That'll give me some room. I've got a tub down on the floor. Right. I forgot the camera's mirror image. Right there. This one. It's got to go in the bedroom because I've got a lot of crap in there that's got to be sorted out. Most of it's got to go in the bedroom anyway. I've got a box full of toy cars I don't know what to do with. Do I keep them? Do I chuck them? Do I jump up and down on them, set fire to them? Drop them on some bastard's head as they walk past the flat? I don't know. But the guy that wanted them has never got back to me, so I presume he no longer wants them. Bloody spider's making his way back this way now. Where is he? He's somewhere up there. You can see the little black dot there. Oh well, I'm going to shut the camera off. 11 minutes is long enough. Okay, I'm not sure if it's the lack of meds or what, but I keep seeing weird things at the corners of my eyes. Could be lack of the medication. They're only fluoxetine, they're not the strongest of antidepressants out there. They're quite a mild, weak one. But, yeah, my God, do they sort of have an effect on you when you stop? That's all they are. I think they're 30 milligram, 20 milligram capsules. Oh, what was I thinking they were 30s? These are the worst tasting pills out of all the ones I have to take. Actually, these ones, my diabetic ones, just quickly. I can actually sit them on my tongue and not taste a thing. They're pretty much flavourless. Well, what is there is tolerable. Same with my own little glycoside ones, which I'm out of. Oops. I don't know why I just failed to keep track of the tray. Unless I've got another tray of those hiding somewhere. I wouldn't be surprised. Right, I'm going to bugger off to bed. Well, as soon as this video's done processing. So I can publish it and whatnot, and then I'll bugger off to bed, so I'll see you when it's daylight, I hope. Flicking the camera around, trying to get the stop button. It's a morning. My little friend has moved all the way back up this end. I think it's spying on me. That's the time. Almost 12:30. Jesus. Right. I'm just going to play a couple of games of solitaire. While I let food settle, and then I'm going to get on with some crap. I have another big clean out, sort out, chuck out, etc, etc. I've got to put a bag in the bin.
Yeah.
Pardon me.
Yeah.
Pardon me. Fuck it. Can't be asked. Well, I had a look in the Catani charity shop again. I've had some more goodies for 50p each. What did I get? Two adapters and another one. So they've got this basket in there of stuff for 50p, and I keep finding all these cables and things in there. That's a 5 volt one. It seems to be quite a common voltage, especially these days, that's why I picked it up. That plug doesn't fit the camera though, so I can't use it on the camera. And this one doesn't seem to be as common. It's a 3 volt output one, 3 volt DC. That's why I picked that one up. Because I have had moments where I've needed low voltage like that. So, in fact, if I get that rubber band off and see what the ampage output is, that would be the perfect voltage to run lights on my Lego town if I ever decide to put them back in. I don't actually know what the amps or the milliamps is on this one. Mind you, if I use LEDs on there, that shouldn't be too bad. Had bocadillo sausage rolls. Yum, 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 yum. Bit greasy, and you can actually peel the flaky pastry straight off the sausage. Because of the way they roll there, so you can just sort of peel it like a skin. But they're nice. But like I said, they're a bit on the greasy side. Ooh, car. Ooh. And bloody cameras are still sitting there. I'm so tempted to go out there one night and just grab them. They've been there a year and a half now, so my logic is, if they were really wanted or worried about, they wouldn't have left them there, A, in all weathers. I mean, they've had frost, rain, sleet, snow, wind, you name it, they've been thrown at them cameras over the last year and a half. You know, to me, if they were really worried about or wanted, they would have been put in one of the storerooms around the corner here. So, I don't know, I might do one day. They do yield some interesting parts. Even the cameras are still there. The cameras, it's not just the domes. The electronics and cameras and everything is still there, look. The camera's attached to that metal bracket where that circuit board is. I do apologise, I don't know. I can't hold the camera steady when I zoom in like that. That's why I want a tripod. Really need a tripod. I keep hoping every time I go down the recycle centre I might find one in the shop. Or a charity shop or anything like that, but no luck yet. But I am looking for one. Today is going to be a bit of a semi-ruthless throw-out day and sort-out. And I'm hoping that Lego box is going to slide under there out of the way. I hope. Because that's something I need to sort out for another day, but I'll need the floor space, so that ain't going to happen yet. Oh, I forgot to take that basket down, because that's for rubbish. I don't really want to put it straight into a black rubbish sack, because that's just going to fill it straight away, more or less. Right. Fucking mess he keeps making. As fast as I clean it up, he mess it up. Right, came in here because I want my refuse sacks. I don't quite think my brain knew whether it wanted to say rubbish or refuse. So it sort of came out as both. Katali actually has, which I am tempted, or was tempted, wind-up battery-operated radio with alarm function and torch for £5. It's got its box with it and everything. I don't really care about the box, but I was just thinking, if I ever have another power cut up here, I'd have one up here, but then again, I've got the one down in the shed, so if I do have a power cut, I could just go downstairs and grab that one. Right, get a bin bag put in there. There's a t-shirt for the dirty laundry basket. I'll take that with me tomorrow when I go to Mum's. I used to do my own laundry till Mum stole my washing machine, with the agreement that she'd do my laundry. And the washing machine died, but she's done the laundry ever since. Because I really can't be asked to drag a heavy washing machine up two flights of stairs anymore. That really is... That's a low plane. Anyway, I'm going to disappear and start getting things done. If I, I'm not actually supposed to park on the car park, but yeah, that's the council rules, and I don't see why. You know, no one's here at the weekend, so who gives a shit? Anyway, I'm going to talk to you later on. Well, I'm taking a bit of a break. And I've got to go across to Lidl for Mum in a little bit. Get a chicken for tomorrow. So I thought we'd have a little bit of fun first. This is Norfolk dialect. And that's Norfolk, England, obviously. And the idea of this quiz is, can you speak Norfolk slang? So... the idea is you've got to read that and then decide which one of these it means. The hell was that? Oh well. Keep your attrotion. I believe that is... oh, I got that one wrong. One wrong. What a load of old squit. And that one is what a load of nonsense. I know that one. Putting on your parts, which is, I know that one as well, having a strop, a bishy Barnaby, I know that one as well, that's Ladybird, stop your blaring, that's stop crying, come along of me. Come along with me. We had a right old Barney. We got really drunk. We enjoyed watching Barney. We had falling out. We had a barn party. We had falling out, boy. How are you going on, boy? How are you getting on, mate? That's what that one is. Have you got a light? That's an obvious one. Have you got a lighter? I blundered over in the rud. I got a funny feeling, that is, I fell over on the road. I want a cuckoo. I don't actually know that one, that's not one I've heard. And some of these aren't as common in Norfolk nowadays. You might hear some of the elderly use them, who were born and bred in Norfolk, but I think it's want a bird. I want a cocoa. Should have seen that one. She ain't too fierce today. She isn't angry today. She isn't very well today. She isn't too windswept today. She isn't too mean today. She isn't angry? No, she isn't very well. I was frizz last night. I was cold. You'll get clipped round the lug. What's a clip round the friggin' ear? You'll be given an ear piercing. No, you'll get a smack around the ear. That's the one. We jammed about. We made jam, we got stuck, we walked about heavily, we spread toast, we walked about heavily. Stop jiffling, that's stop fidgeting, I know what that one is. I've got a shiver in me finger. That, I think, I've got a splinter. Yep. Don't be soft. Don't be silly, that one. Those rolls used to be hooly good. Those rolls used to have holes in them. Those rolls used to be very good. Those rolls are usually wholesome. Those rolls are usually really hard. Those rolls used to be very good. You dizzy woman. Ah! I bet that's you dizzy woman at the top here. Your windows need cleaning, you... Last warning, you silly bad person. You dizzy woman? Ah, you silly bad person. Oh dear, I've got 16 out of 20. That isn't bad, actually. I'm happy with that. I'd be happy if I got a couple more. Yeah. That was a bit of fun. There is a tea towel that you used to be able to buy, a novelty tea towel. I last saw them being sold in Cromer, naturally, because it's a tourist attraction. Or a tourist destination, I should say. It had a lot of Norfolk dialect on it, a lot more than that. I read about that news article. You will be banned for driving for life. Basically, a Range Rover driver. I'm actually going to play the video. That would be the easiest option. Don't worry, it's not a very long video. In fact, we're about to come up to impact now. That Range Rover was chasing the first car that turned into the junction. He denies it, but he pleaded not guilty for chasing the driver of the other car, but witnesses say otherwise, and you can actually see in the video how hard he suddenly turns. To me, indicates he was chasing the car in front of him, and it was a road rage thing. He was chasing the car in front of him for a road rage reason, and he left two little girls paralyzed from the waist down because of his actions. He's now been sentenced to 4.5 years in prison. Which, over here, he'd probably only serve half of that. But I also think he should have a driving ban as well, because he was actually a 4x4 driving instructor, you know. It obviously instructs people how to drive properly off-road. So you would have thought someone like that would have had more common sense, is the word. But he obviously let his temper get the better of him that day, and that has caused two young girls, 8 and 10, I think, to be disabled from the waist down. And it's no wonder I get fucking cross at idiot drivers. I nearly got took out this morning, actually. Usually, on the narrow piece of road which is pretty much only wide enough for one vehicle. Well, it is actually only wide enough for one vehicle. But if I get over on my bike and a car gets over as far as I can, we can usually pass comfortably. It's a bit close, but we can pass comfortably. But this woman didn't. She got a little bit too close to me. But, yeah. Right, I suppose I better go across and get this chicken for tomorrow's dinner. And a couple of bottles of Coca-Cola. A little pocket full of change. But I don't know how much change. Lots of. Yeah, I want to go to the recycling centre tomorrow. I'm having still having a huge muck out. I'm just sort of pottering around. I've got boxes. There was a box I want to sort out. Going through some of my drawers and whatnot. I don't think them bins are going to know what hit them. haven't done a lot in here. I've got an empty box there to go down. I've actually realised I've got a problem with that tub. Not all of the long tools actually go in it, so may have to play swapsies with the tubs. I may have to put it in a tub like this or something. You know, tip that one out and swap. What are you doing, Nemo?
Hello.
Right. I shall talk to you all later. I've still got crap to do. So much crap to do, not enough hours in a day. I've been a busy bee again. I've spent most of my time in the bedroom today. Because I think most of it was just crap that needed putting in the correct drawers or containers. I've sorted a few containers out as well while I was at it. Sort out a bunch of wires that were laying down there. Had a box of plugs and light switches and power outlets and things under the bed. I've actually sorted that out and put in a new tub. And some of the plugs, just like this one down here, I'm going to take to Mum's because they don't have any spare over there. Or very few, so I'm going to take them over and stick in the drawer in the workshop. I had a quick sift through this drawer. There wasn't really that much in there. Not as much in there as I thought, anyway. Most of the cables that were laying down there were power cables, so I've put all those, rolled them all up and put all those in the power cable drawer. I've got a drawer here full of figure eight, clover leaf and kettle leads. There's a couple of kettle leads in there anyway. There's a new one I bought today. Got some carrier bags there to bundle up. I might give them a bunch of them to Mum tomorrow as well. To Mum tomorrow. Try saying that when you've had a few. Jesus. That'd be a bit of a mouthful, wouldn't it? Right. I've just got a few cables to go in that bottom drawer. Next task is to empty all this, them boots and lamps and cables and things out from there. So I can get that box of cars in. I'm actually hoping my new tub of tools over there will sit in front of those. I'm hoping it will go in that gap. If not, that'll have to go up the side there, that's all. Might even be better throwing it up the side there, I don't know. Because it's not a box that I regularly go to. Oh, sugar. That can go in a friggin' bin as well. Pardon me. There's a bit of a squeaky one. Right. I've got a few bits to sort out down here. I forgot to put that light fitting back in the tub. I'll have to do that. It's easy enough to get to under the bed. I need to do a bit of dusting. And I can hear a lot of loud voices outside. And it's a bit concerning because I can't tell, you know, if it's just some people having a bit of a laugh and giggle, you know, or if it's a huge argument or something. I can't quite hear. Dusting, at least dusting the keyboard and whatnot down. Here's my Jervis C camera. Did I do this one? Yeah, I did, didn't I? This is why I keep this brush, it's a good dusting brush. And I'm gonna have to, eventually, go over the Lego table with it. I need like a very small air compressor or something. I know you can get the cans of compressed air, but I'm not paying all that for a can of friggin' air. There's a lot of money just for a can of air. So that's why I don't buy it, but that would be pretty useful. Because there's a lot on here that need it. What I could do with, come to think about it, it's one of those cheap little 12-volt air compressors you get for cars, you know, in case of emergency. If you've got a flat tire, you just plug it into your cigarette lighter and away you go. If I could get hold of one of those, and so I've got plenty of 12-volt DC adapters, so I could easily modify it to run from a plug. Easy enough. then my theory is I should be able just to run the hose all over the town and blow all the dust away. In theory. Well, I thought I had cobwebs on the top of the fire station, but it's not, it's just cat hair. You'll get pissed off with me one day, because that's where the hospital is going, which, seemed to be splitting in half. I must have it sitting on something. That's causing it to bend. Oh well. Right. Well, I've solved my dusting problem, I've just got to get the air compressor. Right, I've got my George grill on, because I'm getting hungry and thirsty, so I'm going to sort some food out. Are you spying on me, Spider? Is that why you keep coming over here? Oh, I've left a drawing pin up there. Whoops. Or thumbtack. Pin. That's three different names for one item. Right. I'll take that down when I lock the bikes up. There may even be another bin bag at the rate I'm going. Might want to keep at least one of those. Those I got to go back in the cupboard. Cool, yeah. My grill is actually smelling rather warm now. Right. Ooh. Got me some chicken. Well, it has been heating up for 10 minutes. Whoops. There we go. Move that out of the way. Peel me box. Fuck, it just made me jump. Do you know what it was? It's just those falling over. So I nudged that one, and it nudged into them. Right, here we go. The other two. Yep, all four, because I'm not putting anything with them. I'm just having the chuck. No, I'll just leave that on there for 20 minutes. I'm going to have to wash a plate though. Right. Cardboard is recyclable. That's going to have to be emptied again. Jeez, can you see all that dust lying on there? Holy moly. I have to take that lot off there and clean that, aren't I? Take this into the bedroom. So I've got some more. I knew I had some more crimps. Crimp connections somewhere. Don't know if I've got enough room. Might have to sit with an open lid. Will it? Oh, no, it will close. That's pretty much full though. It's not often I use those, but they are handy to keep hold of. I'll keep them up here. Actually, I'll put... Yeah. Oh, pardon me. Put them up there. Right. We're good. So I'm going to pissing the off, and that translates to piss off, and get something to eat, and continue with my mission of cleaning up shit. Well, I've just had something to eat. I've had my chicken, and I'm just debating whether or not I wanted to zip across to Sainsbury's, Lidl's. Or the garage, because I've got nothing to nibble on later tonight. I'm sucking on an antacid. Well, I was, it's just disintegrated. Nom nom. It's just like eating mint flavoured chalk, that's what these are. Actually, chalk would get rid of heartburn, but it wouldn't taste very nice. Yeah, so I'm sort of... Well, I've got just over 2 hours before the stores close, I mean. Well, the gas station doesn't close till 10. Well, actually 10:30, but at 10 o'clock they close the main doors. And that's because they used to get a lot of troublemakers going there after sort of 10. So, they decided for staff safety they'd close the main doors at 10. So you can only buy fuel or cigarettes. Because Sainsbury's rule is that the cashier cannot go and get anything unless they can reach it from where they are. So, of course, anything behind the kiosk, and they used to have, I can't remember if they still do, but they used to have things like liquors, whiskies and vodka bottles, and you can get batteries. They have antacids and a few other things there as well, behind the counter, lighters, cigarettes and stuff. That's pretty much all you can get, other than fuel, after 10 o'clock. Don't know why. Well, actually, I do know why, because I just said so. I don't actually know what I said. I don't know why. Sometimes I actually wonder if this thing does actually function, you know? Or if it's this bit of it, I don't know. Because half the time, the brain's thinking one thing, but something else comes out of here. Whoops. I think I might actually throw that. But then again, I've got a Windows Vista laptop, haven't I? I don't know if it's really... Is it worth keeping? Upgrade your Windows Vista experience. I mean, this has never been opened. It's still sealed. But I don't actually know what it's got with it. Certain Windows Vista product features require advanced or additional hardware. Windows Vista Upgrade Advisor can help you determine which features of Windows Vista will run on your computer. To download the tool, visit www.windowsvista.com. Importantly, you must accept the enclosed license terms before you can... Might as well have a play. That's the thing, I'm looking at things and I'm thinking, do I throw it out? Do I not? I'm looking at lots of things. Oh dear. You think I need to sort the coat hangers out in my closet? It's just where I reach in there and just go doof with a t-shirt and they all end up in a mess. Right. I've got so many carrier bags everywhere. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, at least 4 empty ones in the bedroom. And I've got one down here, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, counting what I've got laying around in here, the lounge. And I know I've got about another 8 in the kitchen. I think I'll bundle them all together and I'll give them to Mum, because I've got plenty in the cupboard. Pardon me. Oops. Ooh, Dad is online. Don't see him online much. Unless I just don't notice. Yeah, not a lot going on Facebook. So I've just sat here watching an episode of Salvage Squad. Ate my chicken, so I think I'm... After I go take a piss, I'll be ready to crack on. This lounge actually looks worse than it is. Most of it is just big chunky tubs that need to be put up out of the way. I suppose I better take my toolbox to Mum's tomorrow, because... Well, if I do get any bikes, be it for scrap or not... That reminds me, they never got back to me today. Oh well, maybe you found someone else that took them. Win some, you lose some. So I think I'll take the toolbox with me. I've got a cycle repair, puncture repair case down there for bikes. I'm going to put all my smaller hexagon keys in. And I'm going to bring my tray up from downstairs because I actually realise I don't have much of a selection of small hexagon keys in this toolbox. So I'll sort some of them out and get quite, well, as much of an assortment in that repair kit as possible. Only because there is nowhere in that toolbox to put hexagon keys. My long ones, I can just sit with the screwdrivers like I normally do. That's not a problem. Well, that reminds me, I've got some tools downstairs to bring up. Right, I mustn't forget. I might do that now then. It don't matter if I lock the bikes up now either, because I can soon grab one out of the shed if I need one. Or I could just go for a walk. Recycling is nearly full. I've got one ketchup bottle, one salad cream bottle to go and rinse out. And 2 cola bottles. And I think that bin will be full. I've got a black bag. I'll take that down when I now go downstairs. It's been a lovely day today, by the way. Had several dull, miserable days throughout the week, and today, lovely. I hope it's the same tomorrow. Oh, I've got Mum's chicken for dinner tomorrow as well. It's in my fridge. Actually, I may take that from the top shelf and put it on the middle shelf, because it might freeze up the top there. Not always, but sometimes when I put even a Coca-Cola bottle up there, part of it will freeze. I don't know why. Maybe it's just because it's close to the bottom of the freezer. But hopefully the chick... Actually, I think the chicken will be all right. Right, well, I'm going to shut the camera down, plug the charger in for a little while, and I'm going to go rock a piss and go downstairs, I think. And I've already forgotten what I want to go down there for. Something in the shed I want to go and get. Tools and hexagon keys, that was it. You see what my memory's like? Short-term memory, absolutely shit. Anyway, I'll talk to you later. Nope, no, I won't, because I'm pressing the battery and not the stop button. Try again. Talk to you later. Right. I've done a little bit more, but I think for the past hour and 20 minutes, I've just been listening to a couple of CDs. Through that PC, because this one likes to crash. I don't know why, but every time I tried to play a CD, it'll play so many songs, then it'll just come up with this blue screen and with a message that says something like, your system encountered an error and will reboot by itself. Sometimes it's even come up saying it's collecting some error data or something. Never did that when I had this machine on Windows 7. It's only done it. Well, actually, it didn't do it at first when I had Windows 10, so... Or when I first installed Windows 10. The other thing is, when I plug my headphones into this, my main PC, I get a rattle sound from the right earphone. Not on that PC. And I've just listened to an hour and a half's worth of music and not one rattle. Except when the bass was a bit too much and I had to crank the volume down. But that's to be expected if you crank the volume up too much on a bassy song. But it does it on every song on this machine. So what I've actually done, just in case, I've uninstalled and reinstalled VLC Media Player, just in case it was almost a bloody chair. No, it was squeaking. I wonder what the hell it was. So the only thing I can do now is to run a CD and see if it works. Still waiting on a phone call from Mum, unless she found while I had the headphones on. Should we just have a quick listen? Oh. No. Last time she called was this afternoon when she asked me to go and get a chick chick. Right, as far as further cleaning goes, all I've done is tidied up down there. Don't I look much better now? That's been sorted. Cleared my chair, so if I really want to, I can sit and play some GTA later. And cleaned up all the rubbish that was down there. So, yeah, don't think, and I haven't actually been out to get anything to eat. Got carried away listening to music, so if I want anything to eat, I might have to throw some fries in the oven or something. They're still working nicely, so it's ridiculous. You'd have thought, you know, a budget food chain like Lidl, that also sells all these household bits and bobs, right in the middle of their store, they've got the aisles for that. You'd have thought they'd have been cheap crap as well, but no, they're actually pretty bloody good. Touch wood. But yeah, I am. Like I said, I've had quite a lot of lights from Lidl, and they've all worked very well. These LEDs, they came from Lidl when Lidl had their stock in. Yeah, right. Yeah, I've cleared a few more cables, that's about it. I did remember what I wanted a 5 volt adapter for. I think it's 5 volt. That's my PSP, so maybe one of those with the really small power of that or power connector I've got will fit that. I hope. We can only hope. Well, as far as I know, I'm still going over to Mum's tomorrow. What time? I have no idea. Depends when I'm up and when Mum's ready to come and get me. Ring! I was so laughed if that did that when I said it. She said she'd ring early tonight, because she dozed off last night. That's why she didn't ring me. But she's dozed off again. Bet ya. Right, well, that is operating pretty well for a Windows 7 PC with a dual core AMD. I can't actually remember. Let's have a look-see. 4 GB of DDR2 memory, that should come up. I still haven't found out how to get the control panel on Windows 10 without typing control panel into the search. That's the only way I can get it up. Control panel, that is. I don't have problems getting it up elsewhere. I just totally distracted myself. What was I doing? System. AMD Athlon 64X2 dual core processor. 2.50 GHz. Well, that's not bad. It's not bad, not the best. Yeah, it's registering all 4 GB, 64-bit. Genuine. Ish. Yeah, that's alright. This one's got 3 GHz AMD quad core. I would prefer, if I'm honest, Intel. But that's what I got at the time, that's what I've got to use. I may be getting a little bit more extra cash at the moment, but I still just can't go out willy-nilly and buy myself a brand new motherboard. Now look what I found the other day. I got this just for the giggles. 30,000 clip art. Revival. Does it give a release? Well, that goes up to Windows XP, so it must have been released. Ooh, 16 MB of RAM, that's all it needs. And 10 MB of hard drive space, wow. 30,000 clip art images and it only needs 10 MB of hard drive space. I bet they're all stored on that though, and you've got to put that in every time. It'd be interesting to know if that would work on something newer than Windows XP. I'll have to try it. I don't know if I'd dare try it on Windows 10, because Windows 10 seems to be a little bit touchy. Oh, that's the other thing. I think the problem is the audio on this PC, because I plug in headphones in the front jack, the actual audio jack, not USB, which is somewhere in there, and it does cut out the external audio from the back, but I didn't get nothing through the headphones. Or the earphones, I should say, because I was using earphones for my MP3 player. Weird. Still got an issue there somewhere. Unless it's because I had something plugged in the back audio socket. Don't know. May try again with the subwoofer disconnected or turned off or something. And see if it works. In case there was, a bit of a clash there or something. Oh yes. Now I'm getting a bit of space. I'll be able to get this set up. I don't know which laptop to use though. Probably one of my compacts. Which one should be my guinea pig? Not the IBM, because it doesn't have working audio, because I can't find the friggin' drivers for it. I have my Toshiba. I have several of these compacts that will run it. So, like I said, I could just pick one of my compacts at random and use one of them, because I've got them in the cupboard as well. Yeah, the Windows 3.1 won't be any good. The Dell doesn't have a CD. Does it? Oh yeah, it does. I forgot, because it's got these hot swappable floppy drive and CD drives on this one. And I've left the CD-ROM drive on it, so I could use my Dell. Yeah, that's an idea then. Give the Dell a whirl. You see, I've got to that corner, can't you? Right. Oh dear. Still got crap in here to clean up. I don't know. Oh. I still think that's going to be a bit big for that PSP. It's got a European plug on it, but that doesn't matter. I've got an adapter. I have an adapter. I am prepared. Will you? No, you're going to be too bloody big, aren't you? Yes, you are. You're too big, you bitch. Sure, I've got some more in here somewhere. I'm sure I kept them in here. Or did I chuck them? That don't sound too good. You hear that rattle? What have I got to fit? Well, that's just done at the world of good, hasn't it? Oh. I'm going to rattle now. Oops. I'm actually just going to, in a little while, I'm going to go under the bed. That really does not sound good. It didn't used to rattle. Right, what I'm going to do is I know I've got another 5 volt adapter, and I think it's got a smaller connector than that one, so I'll dig that out in a little while and I'll try that. It's only at the front of my box of adapters, so it's not going to be hard to grab it. These camera chargers I've been putting in my laptop charger drawer. There's a few others in there as well. The only cable I've got to worry about is this one. I think, yeah. I've got to go over there. Right. I wonder what that's for. I can go in my cable box, actually. It was a cable I bodged together to get 5 volts from a USB port. In fact, with all these USB adapters I've got, I don't know if I'd actually need that. No, I better keep hold of it just in case. Just in case. Right. Oh, I found, is it that one? Yep, I found another sticky monster from last year. A little glow-in-the-dark one somewhere, unless I've accidentally sucked it up with the G-Tech, but it was on the floor somewhere in here. Emphasis on was. Another one. My box of LEDs. I think it might actually be. Was it around here? It was somewhere. I can't miss it. It's a white thing. It's going to stand out like a sore thumb on this carpet. Like I said, not unless I've accidentally sucked up the G-Tech. I haven't vacuumed in here, as you can tell. So it may have gone up the G-Tech accidentally. But broken bit of torch. Yeah. Ooh. I'll put that in the box when I go under the bed to get the adapter. I could swear I could hear lots of weird noises outside when I had the headphones on. Yeah, it's quite out there now though. Right. I'm going to call it for the video, I think. So, thanks a lot for watching. The annoying thing is, I'm looking around the flat and it doesn't really look like I've made much of a dent in it, but I have. Well, I can see some progress. It doesn't help when I sit at the PC for long periods of time. Oh well. I'm going to shut that PC down because I don't think I need that running now. I'll probably put the PS3 on and see if I've got anything I can make a snack out of in the kitchen. Not a lot. Well, that's all the ketchup I've got left. That's all the salad cream I've got left. Oh dear. Anyway, thanks for watching and I'll talk to you, if all goes as planned, when I get back from Mum's tomorrow. Bye.